the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Let me make it very clear to everyone that this Bible, which the Christians believe to be the word of God, is not the Injil which we Muslims believe was revealed to Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. This Bible, according to us, it may contain the words of God, but it also contains words of prophets, words of historians. It contains absurdities, obscenity, as well as innumerable scientific errors. If there are scientific points mentioned in the Bible, there are possibilities. Why not? It may be part of the word of God in the Bible. But what about the scientific errors? What about the unscientific portion? Can you attribute this to God? I want to make it very clear to my Christian brothers and sisters. The purpose of my presentation on Bible and science is not to hurt any Christian's feeling. If I hurt your feelings, I do apologize in advance. The purpose is only to point out that a God's revelation cannot contain scientific errors. As Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, search ye the truth, and the truth shall free you. You have the Old Testament, you have the New Testament. Now you should follow the last and final testament, which is the glorious Quran. As far as Dr. William Campbell is concerned, I can be more liberal with him because he has written a book, Quran, Bible in the Light of History and Science. He has given a presentation and he's a medical doctor. I don't have to be very formal with him. As far as the other Christian brothers and sisters are concerned, I apologize if I hurt your feelings during the presentation. Let's analyze what the Bible says about modern science. First, we deal with astronomy. The Bible speaks about the creation of the universe. In the beginning, first book, book of Genesis, first chapter, it's mentioned. It says, Almighty God created the heavens and the earth in 6 days and talks about an evening and a morning, referring to a 24-hour day. Today, scientists tell us that the universe cannot be created in a 24-hour period of 6 days. Quran 2 speaks about six ayams. The Arabic word singular is yom, plural is ayam. It can either mean a day of 24 hours or it is a very long period, an eon, an epoch. Scientists say we have no objection in agreeing that the universe, it could have been created in six very long period. Point number two. Bible says in Genesis chapter number 1, verse 3 and 5, light was created on first day. Genesis chapter 1, verse 14 to 19, the cause of light, stars, and the sun, etc., was created on fourth day. How can the cause of light be created on the fourth day, later than the light which came into existence on the first day? It's unscientific. Further, the Bible says, Genesis chapter 1, verse 9 to 13, earth was created on the third day. How can you have a night and day without the earth? The day depends upon the rotation of the earth. Without the earth created, how can you have a night and day? Point number 4. Genesis chapter number 1, verse 9 to 13 says, earth was created on third day. Genesis chapter 1, verse 14 to 19 says, the sun and the moon was created on the fourth day. Today, science tells us that earth is part of the parent body, the sun. It cannot come into existence before the sun. It's unscientific. Point number 5. The Bible says in Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 11 to 13, the vegetation, the herbs, the shrubs, the trees, they were created on the third day. And the sun, Genesis chapter number 1, verse 14 to 19, was created on the fourth day. How can the vegetation come into existence without sunlight? And how can they survive without sunlight? Point number six, that the Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse number 16, that God created two lights. The greater light, the sun, to rule the day, and the lesser light, the moon, to rule the night. The actual translation, if you go to the Hebrew text, it is lamps. Lamps, having light of its own. And that You'll come to know better if you read both the verses, Genesis chapter 1, verse 16 as well as 17. Verse number 17 says, and Almighty God placed them in the firmament to give light to the earth. To give light to the earth, indicating that sun and the moon has its own light, which is in contradiction with established scientific knowledge that we have. There are certain people who try and reconciliate and say that the 6 days mentioned in the Bible, it actually refers to epochs like the Quran, long period, not 624 days. It's illogical. You read the Bible, evening, morning, it clearly states 24 hours, it indicates. But even if I use a concordance approach, no problem. I agree with your illogical argument, yet they will only be able to solve the first scientific error of 6 days creation, and second, that first day light and third day earth. The remaining four, yet they cannot solve. Some further say that if it's a 24 period, why can't the vegetables survive for 124 days without sunlight? I say, fine. If you say that the vegetables were created before the sun and can survive for 124 days, I have got no objection. But you can't say the days mentioned are 24 hours as well as epochs. You can't have the cake and eat it both. If you say it is long period, you solve point number 1 and 3. The remaining 4 are yet there. If you say the days are 24 days, you solve only point number 5. The remaining 5 are yet there. It becomes unscientific. I leave it to Dr. William Campbell, whether he wants to say it is long period and say that there are only 4 scientific errors, or say it is a 24 days and say there are only 5 scientific errors in the creation of the universe.